Hi, I'm Samantha Lott Hale from Girl Scouts of Maine. I'm the program director here. For those of you who don't know, Maine is located here in the northeast corner of our country. We have lots of forests as well as mountains and a mostly rocky coast along the Atlantic Ocean. Welcome to all the girls watching from across the country and around the world. Today, we are going to observe the world with some activities from the Daisy Think Like a Citizen Scientist journey. We will explore how scientists and animals use observation to understand our world. Scientists study nature and to better understand how it works. They use what they learn to create solutions to help people, animals, and the environment. Scientists use a process called the scientific method to solve the problems and learn new things. One of the first steps of the scientific method is to observe. Observation is watching and noticing something using all of your senses, especially sight. It's the start of every experiment and scientific discovery. This activity will take about 30 minutes to complete. You don't need any supplies, just a sibling, parent, or other family member to help be your partner in the activities. So the first part we're going to do is called playing I Spy. So you're gonna start by playing a few rounds of I Spy with your partner. You're gonna choose an object in the room or outside and say, I spy with my little eye something that is green or another color. Then ask that other person, your partner, to guess the object. After you play each round, brainstorm what other clues you could have given them to guess each object apart from its color. For example, you could have shared how big or small it is or what shape it is. So if we had been outside and I had said, see something green, that would be a lot of things and really hard to guess. So think about some of those other qualities you could add to the I Spy game. The second part that we're going to be doing is learning about observation and the five senses. When we play I Spy, we use our eyes to observe the object's color, shape, or size. Observation is looking at something very carefully and thinking about what you see. These clues, our observations, can help us learn something. Every clue you gave in I Spy is an observation of something you saw, but you can use all of your senses to observe. So find out if you know your five senses. Stand up and point to the body part you use to see, touch, hear, smell, and taste. Give you a minute. Did you point to your eyes to help you see? Your fingers to touch? Ears to hear? Mouth to taste? Nose to smell? All of our senses give us different kinds of information. Even if one of your senses isn't as strong as the others, you can still use it to learn a lot about the world. So part three of our activity today is experience how different animals observe the world. Sometimes we're surprised at what we learn if we look at the world in a different way. So for the next part of the activity, act out what it's like to observe the world as different types of animals. First, pretend you're an ant. How do you see the world? What do you observe? What might you do if you get down very low and pretend you're very, very small? You might need to do that to get that perspective. Now, what if you are a bird? You'll be able to fly high above the ground. What would you see if you're flying? What would you see if you were perched on a branch of a tree or in your nest? Finally, think of two other animals, maybe three, like a cat, a giraffe, or a snake. How do they observe the world? Act out what it's like to be each animal and describe what you're observing. Each of these animals observes the world in a very different way. They use their senses to gather information that helps them to find food or a place to sleep. And that's it. The next time you're observing something, remember to look at the object from different angles. Go close and look at the tiny details. Then step back and think about how the object you're observing fits into everything around it. This will help you learn something new about your world. What about this activity could you share with your parents or friends? What do you want to know more about? Do you want to try to be some more animals? You've now completed part of the Daisy Think Like a Citizen Scientist journey. If you had fun doing this, you might want to learn more about the scientific method, participate in a citizen science project, and take action with the rest of the Think Like a Citizen Scientist journey. Explore other fun activities at girlscouts.org, Girl Scouts at Home, or visit the Girl Scout shop at girlscouts.org. Check out your local Girl Scout Council for more activities as well, or talk to your troop leader. Thank you for watching this video today and doing the activity from the Daisy Think Like a Citizen Scientist journey with me. Go out there and have fun, scientists.